I have to admit that I personally turn to Google Tag Manager as my first choice whenever there's anything beyond the basics in GA4 that needs to be tracked. But every once in a while, we'll work with a client who's unable to use GTM or can't make changes to it for some reason, and then we need to figure out how to track things without the luxury of Google Tag Manager. First, let's talk about tracking specific clicks, such as moving from one page to another. You can use the path exploration that I covered in the lesson, What Does Our User Journey Look Like? But if you want to track movement specifically from one page to another, there's a couple of different ways to accomplish that. One option is to create an audience based on a sequence. Let's start by creating a custom audience. Then we're going to click Add Sequence to Include, and then we're going to remove the original Include Users When option here at the top. Our sequence will be people who visit the home page and then go to the Book an Appointment page. Step one for the condition will be under Page Screen, Page Path, and then we're going to choose Exactly Matches, and then slash for the home page. Then we're going to click on Add Step. We're going to click this drop down here and change it to Is Directly Followed By, and then we're going to select Page Path again. And again, we're going to choose Exactly Matches, and then we're going to search for Book an Appointment. There's the Book an Appointment page. We're going to click Apply. And now we can see that we do have users in this audience, so it's working. And then we can create an audience trigger and record an event anytime the sequence of event occurs. If you wanted to get even more specific and track clicks on a certain button, I would recommend adding in a parameter to the button URL that you'd then see show up in GA4. Very important note, don't use UTMs for this, just make up your own parameter. For example, let's say that the book appointment button in the menu has this URL. Now, let's add a parameter to that. This parameter isn't actually doing anything, at least not on this site. Make sure your own site won't act weird if you use a parameter like that. But what does happen is that it gets picked up by GA4 in the page location dimension. Once you have that in the page location dimension, we can create an event based on the page view event. To do that, we're here in the admin, we're going to click on events, we're going to click on create event, and then we're going to click on create. First, we're going to name our event. Let's call it CTA_navigation. This means that it's a call to action button that's in the navigation. Then for the matching conditions, the event name will be page view, then click add condition. From the parameter list, we're going to select page location. And then we're going to choose contains instead of equals. And then for the value, we're going to enter in our parameter, which is %location=top_nav. Then I'll show you a sneaky trick. If you wanted to create a calculated metric based on how many times this button was clicked divided by sessions, you can do that by scrolling down here and clicking on Add Modification. And then we're going to add a parameter called CTA_navigation_count. And then for the value, it's going to be 1. Save this by clicking on Create, and then we're going to go into the Custom Definitions part of the admin. Then we're going to go into Custom Metrics, and then we're going to create a custom metric, and we're going to add that metric we just created. The metric name can be whatever you want. I'm just keeping it the same as the event parameter for sake of clarity. And then the event parameter would be CTA_navigation_count that we just created. The unit of measurement would be standard because it doesn't have a unit of measurement like time associated with it. Then click on Save. Then we can go into our calculated metrics, click on Create Calculated Metric, and then we're going to call this nav CTA rate. Then for the formula, we're going to find our metric we just added, CTA_navigation_count, and then we're going to divide that by the number of sessions. Click Save, and now we're able to take the number of times that particular event occurs and divide it by the number of sessions on the site. Then we can add a rate in our reports of how often that particular button was clicked. Next, let's consider how to track engagement with things other than clicking links on a website. If you can't use GTM, you are a bit limited since you have to rely on what GA4 gives you. So let's look at how to narrow down engagement with a specific video, for example. There are three dimensions that come with any video event: video provider, video title, and video URL. Back in GA4, we can add these dimensions to any report. For example, we're on the events report. We're going to revise this by clicking the pencil icon, open up the dimensions, and then we're going to add in the dimension of video title. We'll click video title, click apply, and now if we go back to our report, you can see now we have video title in this list. And when we click it, we see our titles come up in the list of events. Unfortunately, what isn't added by default are the metrics for videos. Those are video current time, video duration, and video percent. I recommend adding those as custom metrics. The unit of measurement for current time and duration is seconds, and for percent it's standard. Once you've added in these metrics, you can also use them in your reports. If we want to create events when specific videos are watched or certain amounts of videos are watched, we unfortunately can't use the same method we just used for tracking clicks, as custom metrics aren't available when you're creating a new event based on an existing event. Instead, we'll need to create an audience. If we click Add New Condition and scroll down here to the video section, you can see that we do actually have some options such as video title. Let's click on that, and then we're going to add in a filter and say exactly matches. And then you can see here that when you click into the field, you get options. We're going to pick our key event video and click apply. But now we also want to see people who've reached 50% of the video. Then we're going to click and so we can specify 50%. For our new condition, it's going to be video progress. And I know that you can see here that there's this video 50% played. I find it doesn't actually work. So what we're going to pick instead is video progress. For the parameter, we're going to search for video percent. And we'll say that it equals 50. Click apply. Now in our summary, we do have users in this audience, so we know this is working. Also, if you don't see video percent in the dropdown, you'll need to add that as a custom metric first. Now let's create our audience trigger. We'll click create new. We're going to name this event video 50 key events. And then we can decide if we want to trigger this event multiple times if someone watches the video more than once or not. If you do want to trigger it every time the video is watched by clicking this and then click save, I recommend changing the membership duration to 1 day so that this event will fire at least once a day if someone comes back and watches at least 50% of the video every single day. We can use these same ideas to create audience triggered events based on sequences of events. For example, someone viewing at least 90% of a service page and then starting the form on the book appointment page. Let's go through what that sequence would look like. We'll create a custom audience. We'll remove include users when and click on add sequence. And then the first step of our sequence will be where the page path is slash. So we'll find page, page path, exactly matches, and then slash for the home page, then click apply, then click and for the condition, we're going to choose scroll. We can see here we've got percent scrolled, and we're going to say that this exactly matches 90. Click apply. Then the next step is similar. We're going to be looking for a view of any package page. We're going to click add step. Then in step two, we'll choose the page path again, page screen, page path. And instead of exactly matches, we're going to stick with contains and use package. Then click apply. And then same idea here and choose percent scrolled. Exactly matches, and 90, then click apply. You can see that we do have users in our audience, so this means that our sequence is working. And then we can add an audience trigger as well. We can call this home package page view. And same idea as the other audience. We're going to record this event at least once a day, so we'll check this checkbox, click save, and then the membership duration will be 1 day. That way we're recording this at least once a day, and then we'll trigger an additional event if someone does this again in the future. Hopefully this gives you some ideas on what you can do for advanced visitor engagement tracking fully within GA4 itself.